She's a Mona Lisa. Everyone's lining up to see her. She's a Mona Lisa. Everyone's lining up to see her. There must be something about her features. You'll find her beauty goes much deeper once you get to meet her. You see her walking down the boulevard. She got the posture of a superstar. She looks so fly in those Gucci slides. Yeah, I wonder what she hides under her disguise. Yeah. And all the girls.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Sarah and I make content about beauty, lifestyle, vlogs, and hauls. So if that's your type of thing, keep on watching and hit the subscribe button. It would mean a lot to me because I am trying to grow my small channel. And with that, let's get on to the exciting part of the video. So guys, I finally was able to get my hands on the beautiful, timeless Chanel Classic Flap. This is the medium size with black caviar leather and gold hardware, and I was on the reserve list for about 3 months to get this bag. I put my name down back in January when prices actually just increased. I tried getting it before the price increased, but of course there weren't any in the United States. There is a shortage right now because of COVID and because they're handmade in France and Italy, that basically it just takes a long time to get it. So I actually put my name down at 3 different Chanel stores, which again, I don't know if you're supposed to do that. I feel like sometimes the sales associates get a little bit rude and snide to you if you do things like that, but I wanted to increase my chances of getting this bag, and actually all of them messaged me at the same week within like plus or minus 1 or 2 days of each other. But I ended up getting my bag from the Soho location in New York City, and it was super seamless. She already had my information down from the time I put my name down on the reserve list, so all she had to do was send me an email to this Chanel portal in which I just paid, and then because I live in New York City, messengers service was dispatched and I was able to get my bag within 24 hours. So I just want to do a quick little overview of this bag as well, and it is just so beautiful. Honestly, the caviar is the way to go if you don't want to baby your bag. I truly think that the lambskin looks the most luxurious just because it is super smooth and buttery, but this one is just so durable, and this one is actually harder to get, and it also has a higher resale value. If you look in the secondhand market on places like Rebag and The RealReal, for some reason the caviar leather actually sells or is selling for higher than what the current price is. So the current price of the medium classic flap is actually $6,800, and with New York City sales tax, I ended up paying around $7,430 or something like that. So it is definitely on the pricier side. This is a true investment bag, and you definitely want to take good care of it. So to go through the features here, of course, you have the pebbled caviar leather, you have the turn clasp here, and then on the back, you have, of course, the famous Mona Lisa pocket. And I will open up this baby. I've already been using it, even though I've only had her for a weekend. And basically the top part here you'll see is that little zipper compartment that I guess she must have used to put her love letters in. Although I don't really know what you would put in here, honestly, because it doesn't fit that much. So that's that piece. Then of course the double flap portion comes up, and mine is lined with burgundy like they all are nowadays. And mine is actually a Made in France bag, which I'm super thrilled about because initially I had wanted to buy this bag a full year ago when I was gonna go to Paris before COVID came and the pandemic came and the lockdown was put into place. So I wasn't able to get this bag in Paris, which I was kind of a bit upset about. So I'm really happy that at least the bag that I got was made in France. It honestly doesn't make a quality difference whether it's Italy or France. They're both great, but it's just one of those little things where Chanel is a French brand, and I wanted to get my first Chanel bag, at least the most classic one that I could get, as a made in France. So you'll see again that it has a main compartment here and then a second compartment up in the front, and then actually where the flap is, there's also a compartment back here, but I don't know what you would really use it for. You can probably put like papers and stuff in there, but yeah, that is the main overview of the bag. I love the gold hardware. I think it just looks so luxurious and expensive. And of course the chain does have a good weight to it. The bag is definitely not the lightest bag out there, but it is my everyday bag, but it's a perfect transition bag between going out and also just running to do some errands. It is a great transition piece. And what's made it even better is I heard that there was a shortage in Chanel boxes, but actually my essay was able to give me the Chanel box that it came with, and it also came with all of the original packaging as well. So of course, there's tissue paper in here, and it came with the care booklet. So this one here has the cloth to wipe the leather, and then there is this package here that truly I actually have not read yet. I think this is the care package, but I'm not quite sure. I think it's just, yeah, this is just the care details basically. So one tip here is to keep all of the original packaging or as much as you can, because it does help you when you want to resell your bag. Not that I would resell it, but just something to keep in mind. It also comes with, of course, the classic flap booklet. This booklet here basically shows you the history of the Chanel purse and it being made. And it also has a certificate telling you where you purchased your bag. So mine was purchased at the Soho location. And then I kept all of the tissuing and the felt as well, just because I like storing it with the felt so that the metal hardware does not make indents into the leather. And then, of course, your authenticity card comes wrapped in tissue paper, and I obviously keep it for authenticity purposes. And of course, the little receipt comes with the camellia, and it came with the ribbon as well as the camellia to go with it. So yeah, I'm super thrilled with this purchase. It is honestly one of my most worth it purchases, and I'm just so happy that I got my hands on it. I feel so lucky, and I just am so happy, honestly, guys. This is probably my dream purse, and I'm so glad that I finally have my hands on it. Whatever bag you guys want for this year, keep working towards it, keep manifesting it, and one day you will definitely get it, because that is how I felt about this bag. I've been wanting it for like 4 years now, and this year was my year. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up, because this is probably one of my most exciting videos I think I've ever created so far. So yeah, thank you guys again so much for watching, and I hope to see you guys in my next video. Bye guys!